Today I present the preclinical experiments with perkerine factors in cardiac regeneration. This slide shows the important factors in myocardial regeneration secreted by viable peripheral blood mononuclear cells or apoptotic peripheral blood mononuclear cells. We can see that a lot of regenerative factors are upregulated in higher degree in the apoptotic peripheral blood mononuclear cell secretome as compared with the viable peripheral blood mononuclear cells. Our group compared the two secretomes, and we have found that a lot of regenerative factor can be found in the apoptotic mononuclear cells secretome. This slide shows our first experiments with the perkerine theory. We have ligated the left anterior descending coronary artery of rats and injected the aposec, this is the secretome of peripheral blood mononuclear cells, after 40 minutes of the setting of myocardial infarction. The slide shows that the ejection fraction decreased in the infarcted rats who were treated with medium, but if the rats received aposec intravenously, the ejection fraction increased significantly and the shortening fraction increased also significantly. The left ventricular and diastolic diameter increased in the sham-operated, sham-treated animals as compared with the sham-operated animals, but if the animals received an aposec intravenously, the left ventricular dilation was not so expressed as compared with the medium-treated animals. Gross morphology showed partially preserved left ventricular wall in the aposec-treated animals as compared with the control rats, where we could see thinned myocardial anterior wall according to the acute myocardial infarction. After that, we wanted to prove our theory in a porcine model of closed chest reperfused MI. This model is the most used large animal model simulating the human myocardial infarction and primary PCI conditions. The question is why pigs as an animal model? There are a lot of similarities with humans. For example, the heart anatomy and structure are very similar to humans. The vessel anatomy and location, namely the coronary, renal, cerebral, and peripheral arteries, morphology and location are the same as in humans. The invasive treatment of the vascular diseases with stents or intravascular balloons are similar using the same devices. And the treatment with medicines can be done with the same dose and administration forms as in humans. The heart valve anatomy and function is practically similar as in humans, and also the circulation physiology and pathophysiology are very similar to humans. So that means that it allows a similar model of myocardial ischemia infarction as in humans, and the left ventricular pressure and volume measurements results similar values as in humans. During the myocardial infarction, we see the same rhythm disturbances, for example, the life-threatening ventricular arrhythmias or reperfusion arrhythmias. Very important that the imaging of the heart can be done with the same clinical cameras as in humans. What we see in pigs that we can see in humans too, and vice versa. So we have at first tried to cure the acute myocardial infarction in pig using the large animal model of myocardial infarction. We have used two different settings of ischemic heart diseases in pigs. The first one was that we used the aposec in acute phase of myocardial infarction. And the second was that we used the aposec in the chronic phase of acute myocardial infarction, in the chronic phase of left ventricular dysfunction due to ischemic heart disease. So the first was that we occluded the left anterior descending coronary artery of pigs. This radiology picture shows the guiding wire put in the LAD and the balloon. After the first or second diagonal branch, we have occluded the LAD by inflating the balloon for 90 minutes, followed by balloon deflation causing a reperfusion of the artery. This is similar procedure as or similar a pathological a picture as the primary PCI in a human acute myocardial infarction. After the 40 minutes occlusion, we have infused the EpiSec intravenously in the pigs. This can be also similar settings as in humans. We have to imagine that the patient receives an acute coronary occlusion and receives an STC segment elevation myocardial infarction. The patients or the relatives call the emergency, and in the emergency car, the acute myocardial infarction will be diagnosed. And during this phase, practically an EpiSec can be infused intravenously during the upstreaming phase to primary PCI. After 90 minutes, we have deflated the balloon and made the reperfusion and ended the infusion of the EpiSec. The second setting was the EpiSec in chronic phase of MI. That means that we have created the same reperfused myocardial infarction, but we haven't treated the animals with EpiSec in the acute phase. We have waited approximately 4 weeks to develop the chronic ischemic left ventricular dysfunction called ischemic cardiomyopathy. And after that, we have used the three-dimensional NOGA guidance of intramyocardial injection of EpiSec. The slide shows the NOGA catheter introduced in the left ventricular cavum. And with a steerable needle, we can inject through a NOGA catheter EpiSec into the border zone of the myocardial infarction. Just coming back to the results of the first experimental setting, the EpiSec administration intravenously in the acute phase of myocardial infarction. We see in the macroscopic picture the heart and the very thin wall of the animals treated with the medium. These are the sham-treated animals. And we see the partially preserved left ventricular wall in the EpiSec-treated animals. You see that even if it is not a normal structure, but it is not so thin, not so thin a scar as compared with the medium-treated animals. The infarct size decreased if we injected a higher dose EpiSec as compared with the lower dose EpiSec as compared with the control animals who were not treated with EpiSec. During the experiments, we have seen a lot of indirect effect of EpiSec. For example, we have seen a hemodynamic stability during coronary occlusion. That means the blood pressure was higher and there was no such tachycardia and no pre-cardiogenic shock clinical picture of the animals. We have seen much less life-threatening cardiac arrhythmias. And if the animals developed a ventricular tachycardia and ventricular tachyarrhythmias, the cardiopulmonary reanimation or resuscitation chance was much better in the EpiSec-treated animals. We have seen less ventricular aneurysms in the pathology, less unfavorable cardiac remodeling, and less irreversible changes car formation of the myocardium. All of these led to a better global cardiac function. The changes or improvement of the ejection fraction of the EpiSec-treated animal was 17% as compared with our historical control animals who were not treated with cells or who were treated with stem cell therapy, mesenchymal stem cell therapy. The slide shows the MRI results at the 30 days follow-up after acute myocardial infarction and Epi-Sec infusion, intravenous infusion. Just to see that the medium control animals ejection fraction was 40% as compared with the Epi-Sec treated animals where the ejection fraction was 57%. This resulted in a 17% improvement of the Epi-Sec treated animals' heart as compared with the medium control. The infarct size was significantly lower as compared with the medium control, and the cardiac output was significantly higher. That means the health condition of these animals was much better as compared with the medium control. What kind of effect can be seen after intravenous administration of Epi-Sec? You can think that the intravenous administration of a protein solution might not reach the heart. However, we have seen a direct and indirect effect of Epi-Sec on the heart. We note that even if the infarct-related artery is reperfused after occlusion, we see a lot of unfavorable effect after myocardial infarction. Thus, despite infarct vessel patency, the microvascular function dysfunction can occur, and inadequate myocardial tissue perfusion are often present. It is resulted by activation of the platelets, even if the reperfusion occurs, vasoconstriction of the infarct-related artery, and the local inflammation due to the inflow of the macrophages and the leukocytes into the injured sites. We have shown that Epi-Sec can reduce microvascular obstruction during myocardial infarction. We could prove it with cardiac MRI because the cardiac MRI can see a hypo-enhanced areas in the late enhancement imaging, which shows the microvascular obstruction. We can quantify the size of the and extent of the microvascular obstruction. And with late enhancement cardiac MRI imaging, 3 days after myocardial infarction, after setting of the myocardial infarction and treated with either medium or Epi-Sec, we could measure a significant less extent of microvascular obstruction in the Epi-Sec treated animals. The second effect was that we could show an anti-aggregatory effect in vitro of the Epi-Sec treated animals. And also an indirect effect of Epi-Sec was that Epi-Sec mediates vasodilation. We could show an increased production of inducible nitric oxide synthase. And also ENOS production was significantly higher in the Epi-Sec treated animals. And also in an organ chamber model, we could show a dose-dependent vasodilation of the infarct-related artery after adding of the Epi-Sec to the incubation medium. A further effect of the Epi-Sec that it causes cytoprotection. We could show that the production of the BCL2 and other factors are significantly more expressed in the Epi-Sec-treated animals, so that we can conclude the Epi-Sec induces also cytoprotection. So in summary, the effect of Epi-Sec in the setting of acute myocardial infarction, that it reduces microvascular obstruction, it inhibits platelet activation and aggregation, induces vasodilation, causes cytoprotection and immune modulation, and all of these leads to increased left ventricular function, decrease of infarct size, and decrease of left ventricular remodeling. Just coming to the second setting of the ischemic heart disease simulation in pigs. So this slide shows the Epi-Sec in ischemic cardiomyopathy, the study design, practically, that we have led to develop a myocardial scar in pigs using this reperfused myocardial infarction model. And after that, using the Noga catheter, you see the steerable needle of this catheter, we injected the Epi-Sec intramyocardially through a left ventricular Noga catheter. The slide shows the study design, again, day zero. We have created the closed chest reperfused MI. We have measured the hemodynamics. And day three, we have performed cardiac MRI with late enhancement and measured the left ventricular function by cardiac MRI. Then we have waited 30 days to develop the myocardial scar and left ventricular remodeling. And then we injected the EpiSec or medium randomly chosen animals percutaneously intramyocardially. 30 days later, we have performed a control MRI and measurement of cardiac function, control angiography just to prove that the infarct-related artery remained open, and we have performed hemodynamic measurements. The slide shows the MRI and hemodynamic measurement results. The baseline parameters were similar. In the medium and EpiSec-treated animals, there was no difference between the two groups. 30 days after intramyocardial injection of the EpiSec, the left ventricular function increased approximately with 7%, which was just not significant. But if we compared the changes in ejection fraction in the medium and EpiSec-treated animals, there was a significant increase in the EpiSec-treated animals. Accordingly, the relative infarct size decreased in the EpiSec-treated animals, which has led to increase of the cardiac output and cardiac index of the EpiSec-treated pigs. The myocardial stiffness and the left ventricular end diastolic pressure decreased in the EpiSec group, which shows the improved diastolic function of these animals after myocardial infarction. The slide shows just an example of the EpiSec and medium-treated animals. In MRI picture that you see that the left ventricular volume is preserved as compared with the dilated left ventricle in the medium-treated animals. You see the preserved left ventricular wall with the small thinning of the anterior wall and septum as compared with the very thin wall, anterior and septal wall, with a large late enhancement showing a large infarct size in the medium-treated animals. The transmurality map of the MRI shows a similar baseline conditions of the EpiSec and medium-treated animals, but the EpiSec animals showed a less transmurality of the infarction as compared with the medium-treated animals. You see the blue shows the less transmurality, the red shows a higher transmurality. The difference is obvious in showing a benefit of the EpiSec if injected in the border zones of the myocardial infarction. This is the transmurality map of the NOGA mapping, showing that at the baseline injection, baseline conditions were similar in the two groups. You see these small injection sites around the infarction site. This was injected in the border zones of infarction in both groups, but less transmurality in the EpiSec-treated animals and the higher and extended transmurality and extension of the infarction showing a remodeling of the left ventricle of the medium-treated animals. NOGA endocardial mapping showed a significantly better viability of the infarcted myocardium in the wall left ventricle in the EpiSec-treated animals, and the significantly higher voltage values also in the bipolar maps, and trend to improvement of the local linear shortening, which is the index of the local wall motion of the infarcted area and the border zone of the infarcted area. This is a picture of the NOGA mapping. This is practically a 3D picture, which is transposed to polar map, a two-dimensional polar map. Again, you see the injection sites of the medium or EpiSec. This is an medium-treated animals. You see that the 30 days follow-up, the infarct is extended, showing higher transmurality and less variability of the original myocardial infarction area. In contrast, the Episec treated animals showed a decrease of the infarct size and less non-viable area and more viability of the previously treated site. Histology showed a similar infarct area of the Episec and medium treated animals, but the border zone was filled with more myocytes in the Episec group, which was confirmed by the higher number of the CD31 positive cells in the Episec treated animals, and more extended in the border zones of infarction. And we have found more c-kit positive regenerative cells in the Episec treated animals in the border zones of infarction as compared with the medium treated animals. Gene expression profile showed a lot of down-regulated genes in the Episec treated animals. That was a surprise for us because we have expected that some kind of regenerative genes should be overexpressed in the Episec treated animals, but the gene expression showed just only downregulation of some kind of factors of the infarcted zone. And if we have extended the gene expression profile to the border zone of infarction, we have seen downregulation, a marked down, significant downregulation of the caspase 1, which is the apoptosis-related protein or enzyme, and a significant downregulation of the tumor necrosis factor alpha. And we have seen a lot of down-regulated genes, but interestingly, we have found some genes which were upregulated. Interesting is that almost half of the genes which show the significant downregulation or upregulation, they still do not have a name or function. That might be that this regenerative factor can be found in these genes, but we do not know the exact function and not even the name of these genes. If we extended the significance level from 0.05 to 0.1, to better understand and explain the biologic mechanism of the regeneration induced by Episec, we have found a lot of other genes downregulated and a lot of some kind of upregulated genes. For example, the known regenerative factors were upregulated, for example, the angiogenic factor, insulin-like growth factor, or the Krupp-like factor 11, and also the significantly upregulated NADP-dependent steroid dehydrogenase-like gene, which is responsible for cell metabolism. And also the myosinin 1 was significantly upregulated, which gene is responsible for the contractility of the left ventricle. We have found a lot of down-regulated genes which are responsible for inflammation and necrosis. Cell survival signaling pathway showed the downregulation of the caspase 1 again, which is responsible for the upregulation of the interleukin 1 beta, which is a known strong inflammation factor, which is responsible for fever, maturation, dendritic cell, and CD4 cell proliferation. PCR confirmed the significantly downregulation of the caspase 3 gene in the border zone of the infarction in the Episec-treated animals, and also a significant upregulation of the myocytes enhancing factor 2C, which is responsible for the contraction, myocardial wall contraction. And we have found a trend towards increase of the myogenin in the border zones of infarction in the Episec-treated animals, and together showed also a trend not only in the border zone but also in the infarcted area of the Episec group. But interestingly, we have found no difference between the two groups regarding the CL12, TGF-beta3 or MMP9, or there was just only a very small change in the HIF-1 alpha, But we have to consider that all of these measurements have been done 1 month after the injection of the EpiSec. So it means, however, that even 1 month later, the EpiSec effect was preserved, and even 1 month later, the apoptosis was significantly decreased in the EpiSec-treated animals. In summary, they presented large animal models of acute and chronic myocardial ischemia studies, demonstrated the efficacy of prekallikrein factors as a cell-free therapy in myocardial regeneration. A single intravenous infusion of EpiSec reduced infarct size and increased global left ventricular function. Additionally, EpiSec reduces microvascular obstruction, inhibits platelet activation aggregation, induces vasodilation, and causes cytoprotection and immune modulation. In the chronic myocardial ischemic left ventricular dysfunction study, EpiSec injection was associated with reduction in infarct size and significant increase in left ventricular ejection fraction, which are accompanied by improvement in contractile function. Gene profiling analysis of the EpiSec-treated animals revealed downregulation of inflammatory and apoptotic genes. Post-hoc validation of gene expression by real-time PCR showed higher levels of expression of myogenic factor, myogenic enhancing factor C2, and the robust downregulation of apoptosis regulator caspase 3. Finally, I would like to thank you, all of my colleagues of the work, and the Kaposvár group, where we have done the large animal experiment. Thank you.